Robertson versus Miranda Maverick is probably going to happen for at UFC 258. It's booked, so let us put on a brief analysis. Jillian Robertson, the savage 5'5", her reach is 63 inches. She changed. She was switching between strawweight and flyweight, and yeah, she's coached by Dean Thomas and Daniel Donaldson, and she's black belt in BJJ. 9-5 is her score, amateur record 9-1. She has most wins in UFC Women's Flyweight Division 6, most stoppage wins in UFC Women's Flyweight Division 5, most submission wins in UFC Women's Flyweight Division 4, and tied with Roxanne Modafferi and Katlyn Chookagian for most fights in the UFC Women's Flyweight Division history with a score of 7. She choked out Courtney Casey, Veronica Macedo, Molly McCann, Emily Whitmer, and also stopped Sarah Frotta. But she was losing to Mayra Bueno Silva via armbar, which was kind of surprising loss. She was stopped via TKO by Macy Barber, and she lost to Tayla Santos via decision. Also, before inking UFC contract, she holds notable victories over Hannah Cyphers, Monica Medina, Mickey Rogers, and unanimous decision losses to Hannah Goldie and Cynthia Calvida. Miranda Maverick. Miranda feared the Maverick, 5'3", 65 inches is her reach. Interestingly, Miranda Maverick is going to have reach advantage despite she is a smaller opponent. BJJ kickboxing, Muay Thai fighter, brown belt in BJJ, riding a score of 8-2. Miranda feared the Maverick is a very, very powerful fighter. And in exhibition record, she holds notable wins over Victoria Leonardo and Shanna Young. She holds a submission win at Invicta FC over Victoria Leonardo, Kellen Schwartz, also and Samantha Diaz. Also decision win over Gabby Romero, but decision losses to Walker Sanchez and Dana Bennett. At Invicta FC, she avenged losses. She avenged the loss to Dana Bennett to win Invicta FC Phoenix Series 2 flyweight tournament. She outworked Pearl Gonzalez, and she stopped Liana Giorgio. Many people were criticizing me when I picked Mav for that fight, but I simply knew that she's going to win. Miranda Maverick has never been finished. I mean, finished via submission, finished via TKO, KO. She is very chinny. I mean, she can take a kick. She can eat a punch to the face. She can eat a knee to the face. This girl is incredibly tough. Jillian Robertson is very, very tough too. You can't question that. When it comes to stamina, well, this is going to be a weird parameter, you know, because we got Miranda Maverick with 2 decision wins. We got Jillian Robertson with also 2 decision wins, but only 1 decision win in UFC over Poliana Botelho, which is known as, Poliana Botelho is not a cardio machine, we all know that. So when it comes to cardio, I'm kind of unsure, maybe slight advantage to Miranda Maverick. When it comes to striking, I don't know. She stopped Liana Giorgio, so I would also give advantage to Miranda Maverick. When it comes to submission game, absolutely Jillian Robertson, but here's the problem. Miranda Maverick has very good submission defense, and she has very good sweeps and transitions, so it's gonna be very, very, very hard to finish her. Despite Jillian Robertson is BJJ black belt and very skillful on the ground, Miranda Maverick is brown belt in BJJ, and she has very good submission defense. Both of these girls are better on the ground, but I think Miranda Maverick has to keep the fight standing and to push it to the later rounds if she wants to win. I kind of don't see a finish here in this fight, but I am going to pick Miranda Maverick for that fight. I know.